I truly stand on the shoulders of giants with huge hearts and afforded me the opportunity to live my dream. My passion had for this wrestling business is evident. It's in my DNA. It's my entire being. With all of you. Let's do this for the people, twins.
Hell yeah. Oh my God.
Sorry if I get emotional because for me, going with a huge wrestling fan, still to this day, and to the series of the Hall of Fame, Abukishi Batu, and I watched all this in Us. So happy for you, Abukishi. You are my favorite. I respect your family.
Really cool to see Wonder Boy first out of the scene. This is one of the first women that I've seen go out there and get it herself.
Wonder Please.
AWA Women's Championship in just over a year of competition. Oh. Upon her revitalizing the division, all while establishing dominance amongst the competition with three women's championship title reigns. Her immense popularity brought the women's championship back to the forefront of WWE in the mid-1990s, as she became the first female to defend the title at WrestleMania in nearly a decade. But when Blaze left WWE and joined rival WCW, she sent shockwaves throughout the industry, with one of the most iconic moments in the history of the Monday Night War.
Electric Blaze showing up and trashing the women's championship.
world. This is real war.
Throwing the WWE Women's title into the trash can on Nitro
completely changed the perception of women in this industry to this very day.
Although the moment will go down in the annals of sport entertainment history as one of the most rebellious acts ever, Blaze's career is equally as historic. Her unique style and countless accolades, which include 7 women's championships across the globe. She showed up to fight. First, found out I was going to be inducting Blunder Blaze. I had to tell somebody. And I'm so glad that I did because I have an awesome story. And I hope Arn Anderson won't be mad at me for telling this. So, when Blunder worked in the WWE, she was backstage and she was working on a promo. And like all of us divas, she was a perfectionist, so she probably worked on it maybe 5, 10, 15, okay, let's just say 20 takes, right, Arn? So Arn was waiting in line behind her, waiting to cut his promo, and damn it, he had a promo to cut and a workout to do, and he was ready to go. Well, Alundra, she wasn't having it, and basically the story ends with the enforcer, Arn Anderson, running for his life with a scared look on his face, a timid dog. Blundra was running after you with her heels, wasn't she? In her hand. And it's those moments that really, really make me proud to be inducting this very, very special woman. There's a quote by Randy Pausch from the book The Last Lecture. He says, "The brick walls are there for a reason. The brick walls are not there to keep us out. The brick walls are there to give us a chance to show how badly we want something. They're there to stop the other people."
The London Ways.
Oh. Yeah, I bet you never saw this coming, did you?
Paul Heyman.
The High Foundation is steeped in rich history and tradition.
Yeah, it's not that she aged, but she looks
and
good.
And I am so proud of you to be carrying on the hard legacy for generations to come. Yeah, that's one hot broad, I'll tell you that. I don't know about being stacked and all of this stuff, but honey, thank you. I am extremely honored and humbled to be standing alongside the entire 2015 WWE Hall of Fame class this evening. It really is truly an honor. After thank you, Lillian, for paving the way.